अस्सलाम वालेकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहू। वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट फॉर आर केमिस्ट्री लेक्चर, दैट इज़ योर चैप्टर नंबर 15, इंट्रोडक्शन टू पॉलीमर केमिस्ट्री। इन आर लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड टिल पॉलीस्टर, इन दैट वी हैव स्टडीड प्रिपेरेशन ऑफ टेरिलीन पॉलीमर। टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी some more important polymers, that is your bunia s rubber, neoprene, biodegradable polymer and much more. Let's start with bunia s rubber. Bunia s is an elastomer. What do you mean by elastomers? You are very much familiar with the term elastomers. In a previous lecture we have studied about the same. The polymer which on stretch it elongate, and when it is force has been relaxed it regain its original position, that it possesses the property of elasticity. So bunia s comes under elastomer polymer, which is a copolymer of styrene and butadiene. Here copolymers means here we are using two different monomer, so it is a copolymer of monomer styrene and butadiene. We are using two different monomer for the preparation of bunia s rubber, that is your styrene and butadiene. Its trade name is SBR. SBR means styrene butadiene rubber. SBR is your styrene butadiene rubber. The polymer is usually obtained from 75 parts of butadiene and 25 parts of styrene. It means 3:1 ratio. Butadiene is 3:1 and styrene is 1. 75 part is your butadiene and 25 part is your styrene. And these are subjected to addition polymerization by action of sodium. Here it undergo addition polymerization. We are very much familiar what is addition polymerization, when two monomer will link together and it undergo polymerization process, it gives you polymer without the elimination of any small molecule. So these butadiene and styrene in 3:1 ratio undergo addition polymerization by action of sodium. It is vulcanized with sulfur. We know what is vulcanization. It lets the polymer to be more stiffer, more stronger. So it is vulcanized with sulfur. Bunia S is superior to natural rubber with regard to its mechanical strength, and it has abrasion resistance. So it is used in tire industry. We are using tire in our vehicles. So due to its superiority to natural rubber, as it has more mechanical strength and has abrasion resistance, so it is used in tire industry. Let's see the preparation of bunia s rubber. Here we require two different monomer. First is your 1,3-butadiene, and second one is your styrene. The ratio is 3:1. 75% is your butadiene, 1,3-butadiene, and 25% is your styrene. See the structure of 1,3-butadiene. Bute means 4 number of carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 number of carbon is present. Di means 2. In means 2 double bond will be present. Bute means 4 number of carbon. Di means 2 double bond. In means 2 double bond. So here di means 2 double bond. So and at which position 2 double bond is present? It is present at first position and third position. Let's see from the structure CH2 double bond CH single bond CH double bond CH2. So this is your 1,3-butadiene plus styrene. See the structure of styrene, C6H5, that is your benzene ring. C6H5, that is the benzene ring or phenyl ring, which is attached to CH double bond CH2. So this is the structure of styrene. What will happen over here, student? The double bond of butadiene. See the structure of butadiene, where the double bond is present, it has been converted into a single bond, and that carbon have opened it link or branch to link with the another monomer molecule. CH2 single bond, CH double bond, CH2, CH2 single bond. So your double bond has been converted into a single bond, and that carbon has opened its branch. CH2 single bond CH. Now this carbon is having an electron, and your double bond is present. That double bond has been converted into a single bond. This carbon will having an electron. As these two carbon, single bond is present over here, that single bond will be converted into a double bond. So your double bond will be, and this carbon will link another monomer molecule. Fine, this is your 1,3-butadiene. The another 1,3-butadiene, this is your CH2. It has linked with this carbon, single bond CH, double bond CH, CH2. So this is your second 1,3-butadiene. The ratio is 3:1. So 2,1,3-butadiene has been done. Styrene C6H5. Fine, C6H5 CH CH2. This is your styrene. Fine, CH2 CH C6H5. This is your another 1,3-butadiene. So here, student, the double bond here, it will be converted into a single bond, and these two carbon will open its branch, and your double bond will form. Whereas in styrene, this two carbon double bond has been converted into a single bond. These two carbon will link with the another monomer molecule. So this is 1-butadiene, 1,3-butadiene, second and third, and one styrene molecule. In so the preparation has been done in 3:1 ratio, 3 molecule of 1,3-butadiene and 1 molecule of styrene. It gives you Buna S rubber. So here we have prepared Buna S rubber from 1,3-butadiene and styrene. What is the property of Buna S rubber? As you know, it is superior to natural rubber, that is a natural polymer, with regard to its mechanical strength and has abrasion. So it is uses in tire industry. This is the property and this is the uses of Buna S rubber. Now next polymer is your neoprene. Neoprene is a synthetic rubber which is obtained by condensation polymerization. Here it undergo condensation polymerization, in which a small two monomer will link, and there will be liberation of small molecule, and it gives you polymer. Here monomer is your chloroprene. What is chloroprene? It is your 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. Chloroprene polymerize rapidly in presence of oxygen. So the process of polymerization will take place fast in the presence of oxygen. Vulcanization of neoprene take place in the presence of magnesium oxide. Here vulcanization will take place in the presence of magnesium oxide. Let's see here the preparation. This is your chloroprene, that is your 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. This is the structure of 1,3-butadiene, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is your 1,3-butadiene. एट सेकेंड कार्बन, दिस इज योर सेकेंड कार्बन, एट सेकेंड कार्बन क्लोरीन इज प्रेजेंट, सो इट इज योर क्लोरोप्रीन एंड इट IUPAC नेम इज 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. It undergo polymerization process. The double bond which is present over here has been converted into a single bond. This double bond has been converted into a single bond. This carbon will having it electron. This carbon is will having it electron. Here the double bond, it is converted into a single bond. Both the carbon is having it electron. This carbon will link another molecule of monomer. This carbon will link another molecule of monomer. And here double bond will form as you see in the product. This carbon has opened its branch to link with the another molecule of monomer. This is a CH2 single bond CCl, double bond CH, single bond CH2. N numbers of time. So from chloroprene we have prepared neoprene. So this is the preparation of neoprene from chloroprene or 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. What is its properties? It is resistant to petroleum. Vegetable oil, light as well as heat. It means it has a resistivity power, especially particularly to petroleum, vegetable oil, light as well as heat. What is it uses? Neoprene is used in making hose pipe for transport of gasoline where the gas has been transported and making gasket. What do you mean by gasket? In our pressure cooker, we are applying a ring-like substance. We are stating at rubber in our day-to-day life. What is the property of that rubber? It helps us not to escape the gas from the cooker. Fine. While we apply that rubber on the pressure cooker, the gas is not being escape out from the vessel. So that is your gasket. It is used in insulator cable, jacket belts for transport, power transmission and conveying. So this is the uses of neoprene. We are moving further toward vulcanization of neoprene. How the vulcanization process of neoprene took place, its mechanism. As we have studied that vulcanization of neoprene occurs in presence of magnesium oxide. So here student you see, this is your magnesium oxide, this is your magnesium oxide. This is your neoprene. Fine, this is your neoprene, this is your neoprene. What will happen over here student? This Mg, it will grab chlorine from here. This Mg will grab chlorine. Fine, so this carbon and this carbon will become unstable. Mg will take the chlorine, MgCl2 will be liberated out. As this MgCl2 will be liberated out, this carbon will become unstable. Fine, so this carbon and this carbon will form bond with each other with oxygen linking. Your oxygen linking will be there, as you see over here, CH2CO double bond, everything will be as it is, nothing will change. MgCl2 will be liberated out and that two carbon will link each other by oxygen linking. Here you see. So this is your vulcanization of neoprene. So your vulcanization of neoprene took place. It is a very simple reaction. You take neoprene, treat it with magnesium oxide. Magnesium will grab the chlorine. The carbon which has given it chlorine will become unstable. That carbon will link to each other by oxygen linking. And you have formed vulcanization of neoprene. Let's move forward towards biodegradable polymer. What is your biodegradable polymer? It is your polymer which can be degraded. Nowadays, in spite of large number of useful applications, Polymers are blamed for creating environmental pollution. To strike the golden mean, certain new biodegradable synthetic polymers have been developed. Here, aliphatic polyester and polyamide with large proportion of polar linkage are one of the important classes of biodegradable polymer. Some important biodegradable polymer we are going to study in this lecture. Disposed natural waste are usually attacked by soil microbes and get degraded to humus. But most synthetic polymer and plastic cannot be degraded by microbes, and they stay in the environment for a very long period of time, which poses pollution problem. So to overcome this problem, biodegradable polymer are being developed. These polymer contain fundamental groups similar to those in biopolymer, such as proteins. Aliphatic polyester are also an important class of biodegradable polymer. First biodegradable polymer which we are going to study is your PHPV. PHPV is a copolymer. Copolymer means here two different monomer we are using, and that two different monomer are two bifunctional. Two bifunctional means it means that monomer containing two functional group in it. Fine. First, the monomer we are using in the preparation of PHPV is your copolymer. Monomers are different, and that monomers contain two bifunctional, that means they containing two functional groups. Beta hydroxy carboxylic acid means it containing hydroxyl group as well as carboxylic group in the structure. First monomer is your beta hydroxy butyric acid. It is also, its IUPAC name is 3-hydroxybutyric acid. And the second monomer is your beta hydroxy valeric acid. Its IUPAC name is 3-hydroxymentonic acid. Here, what will happen, student? Hydroxyl group of one monomers will form ester link. As we know the general formula for ester. So hydroxyl group of one monomer will form ester link by reacting with carboxylic group of another monomer. Where is the reaction taking place? Hydroxyl group of one monomer and carboxylic group of other monomer, where they form an ester linkage. Fine, student? So thus, PHPV is an aliphatic polyester with name poly beta hydroxy butyrate co beta hydroxy valerate. What is the full form of PHPV? It is your poly beta hydroxy butyrate co beta hydroxy valerate. This is degraded by microbes in the environment as it is your biodegradable polymer. Let's see here the preparation. This is your beta hydroxy butyric acid. Butyric. Bute means phone number of carbon 1, 2, 3, 4. This is your phone number of carbon. Butyric acid, first carbon containing COH group, CH2, CH, CH3. Now this is your beta hydroxy. This is your functional group. Linked to this functional group, this is your alpha carbon. This is your beta carbon. Which carbon containing hydroxyl group? Your beta carbon containing hydroxyl group. So your beta hydroxy butyric acid. This is your first monomer. Second monomer is your valeric acid. Valeric means 5 number of carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is your valeric acid. And hydroxyl group is present at beta carbon. This is your alpha carbon. This is your alpha carbon. This is your beta carbon. Hydroxyl group is attached to this beta carbon. Fine. So this is your second monomer, beta hydroxy valeric acid. So here what will happen over? How the reaction will take place? As we know, hydroxyl group of one monomer will react the carboxyl group of another monomer. Fine. This what will happen over here? Water molecule will be liberated out. How the water molecule will be liberated out? OH will give it hydrogen, and our carboxylic group will give it your which group? OH group. So your water molecule will be liberated out. And see, OH group is giving your hydrogen. Fine. So your hydrogen is being liberated out. O, CH, CH, CH3. Fine. CH2, CH2, C double bond O, C double bond O. Fine. This is your first monomer, and it is linked with another monomer. With the liberation of water molecule will be liberated out. This is your O, C, CH2, CH3, CH2, C double F. It will give it OH n numbers of time. Fine. So here it has been prepared PHPV, that is your poly beta hydroxy butyrate co beta hydroxy valerate. This polymer is prepared by condensation polymerization method. So what is the monomer? The name of the monomer is your beta hydroxy butyric acid and beta hydroxy valeric acid. Its IUPAC name is 3-hydroxybutyric acid and 3-hydroxypentonic acid. So here student, we have prepared PHBV from the monomer 3-hydroxybutyric acid and beta hydroxybutyric acid and beta hydroxyvaleric acid. We are moving further towards nylon 2, nylon 6 polymer. This nylon 2, nylon 6 polymer is prepared by condensation polymerization method. It is a polyamide copolymer of two amino acid. Here again student, it is copolymer. We are using two different monomer for the preparation of nylon 2, nylon 6, and it is again a bifunctional. It containing two functional group, amino and acid. It is your biodegradable polymer. Glycine and E amino caprylic acid is the name of the monomer which we are using for the preparation of nylon 2, nylon 6 polymer. Here the numeral 2 and 6 stand. In the name of this polymer, you see 2 and 6 number. It stands for number of carbon atom in the bifunctional monomer. 2 stands for the first monomer in which 2 carbon is present. 6 stands for the second monomer in which 6 carbon is present. And that monomer is your bifunctional, means it containing 2 functional group in its structure. Let's see its preparation. So here, 1 number of carbon, 2 number of carbon. Fine. So it is your 1, 2. So it stands for nylon 2. And here 5 plus 1, 6. So here it stands for 6 number of carbon. Fine. This is your glycine, NH2, CH2, COH. Two functional group is present, NH2, COH. So this is your glycine, NH2, CH2, COH. And this is your E amino caprylic acid. Here NH2, CH2 5 times COH. Both the monomer contain two functional group. One is your amino, another is acid. NH2 is your amino, COH is your acid. What is the structure of glycine? NH2, CH2, COH. And what is the structure of E amino caprylic acid? It is your NH2, CH2, 5 times COH. What will happen over here? These two monomers will undergo condensation polymerization. What it undergo? It undergo condensation polymerization. There will be removal of small molecule. Which molecule will be liberated out? Water molecule will be liberated out. Here student, this carboxylic group will give it OH. And NH2 group will give it H. It will give it H and this will give it OH. And water molecule will be liberated out. fine. So let's see over here, NH2 will give it, the structure has been shifted, just rotate the structure. This is your COH, fine, that COH will give it OH, OH will be liberated out, and this is your COH, OH has been removed out, OH has been removed out. This is your CH2, this is your NH2. This H2 has been converted into NH. Finally, this NH2 has been converted into NH. This NH has been linked with this COH. This is your this COH. OH has been liberated out. Fine. OH has been liberated out. And water molecule OH plus H, that is your H2O, will be liberated out. And these two will form a bond. C double bond O. This is your CH2, this is your NH. Here H will be liberated out. And this NH will open its branch, this COH will liberate OH, and C carbon will open its branch n numbers of time. So this is your nylon 2, nylon 6 polymer. Nylon 2, nylon 6 polymer. 2 stand for 2 number of carbon for glycine, 6 stand for 6 number of carbon for E-amino caprylic acid. Here we have taken 2 monomer glycine. What is the structure of glycine? NH2, CH2, COH. Better you rotate the structure, COH, CH2, NH2. It will be easy for you to undergo the condensation polymerization to remove the water molecule. Fine, E-amino caprylic acid, rotate the structure, COH, CH2, 5 times NH2. Fine. So here we have taken 2 monomer glycine and E-amino caprylic acid. It undergo polymerization, condensation, water molecule has been liberated out. NH2 will liberate it hydrogen, COH will liberate it OH, water molecule has been removed out from that, and that carbon and nitrogen will form a bond. And you are obtaining nylon 2, nylon 6 polymer. So here student, we have completed some important polymer. In the next lecture, inshallah, we are going to study some more topics such as commercially important polymer. In that we will study acrylic glass, Buna N, PVC, polyacrylamide, urea formaldehyde resin, and much more. How, which monomer we are going to use, and how the polymer structure will be there, what is its application. Inshallah, we are going to study in the next lecture. Study it well. It is a very simple preparation. So student, today we have studied Buna S rubber, its properties, its uses, its preparation, and then we have studied neoprene rubber, its properties, its preparation, its uses, and how neoprene has been vulcanized. We have studied its mechanism, how neoprene has been vulcanized, how it vulcanization of take process took place. And then we have studied biodegradable polymer. What is biodegradable polymer? In that we have studied PHPV polymer, which monomers, what is its properties, and how it has been prepared, its preparation. Then we have studied nylon 2, nylon 6 polymer, how it has been prepared, what is it method of preparation. Inshallah, in the next lecture, we will study much more. Study well. As per your new syllabus, for some of the topic has been removed. So we have not studied that topic. Classification has also been removed. But we have studied that topic, we have done with that topic as a deletion portion has been came later onwards, so we have completed that classification. After that, what has been removed from the chapter we have not studied, that is the phenol, formaldehyde and related polymer, in that bakelite, melamine, formaldehyde, viscon, rayon, molecular mass and degree of polymerization of polymer. This all topic has been deleted from your chapter, so we have not studied that chapter. We have not studied that topic from the chapter. Rest all the topic we have studied. Inshallah, in the next lecture we are going to study some commercial important polymer. Till then, take care, study well. Thank you.